Good afternoon, guys. My name is Brandon, and with winter approaching, it means we're going to be doing a lot more stuff inside, and we're going to try to be keeping the heat in and the cold out. So that's what today's episode is about. Stick around. So if you're like I am, you do a lot of welding inside, you're working on bikes inside, fixing stuff, lawnmowers, creating fumes, painting inside, and it's not good to breathe that stuff in. It's good to vent it out if you can. Well, what we're going to be working on today is we're going to build an inexpensive, budget-minded ventilation system that you guys can build at home for your home workshop, and it's going to be a breeze with easily sourced out materials. Let's get going. So guys, here's my motorcycle lift. This is also going to allow me to slip on some tubing so I can run the bikes inside and not have to worry about venting the exhaust fumes outside. But, you know, picture this also being a workbench, because this is my workbench. And if you guys are welding or spray painting, this is going to help evacuate some of those fumes. So what I'm going to start out with is we're going to have a flexible duct that comes down. That's going to be a dryer duct. I'll show it all to you. We're going to run some solid pipe overhead. That's the solid pipe there. Here's that flexible duct. It's 4-inch duct and it's 8-inch and it's used for dryers. It's metal, so you don't have to worry about it burning anything down. And we've got just a low-cost 4-inch inline duct fan. And I've got some self-tapping number 8 by 1/2-inch screws, and I got a little bit of pipe strap. This is left over from something else I was working on, but you can buy this in a roll. It's made to like, it's pipe hanger. It's just inexpensive pipe hanger, but that'll probably do what we need to do. And I picked up everything I just showed you for right around 60 bucks. Now the first thing you gotta do is you gotta put this little seam together. I'll show you what that looks like. That fits in kinda like that. I don't remember the name of this. I think it's called a Pittsburgh seam. I could be wrong. You know, I've heard or seen guys on job sites that are tin knockers. I don't know. I think that's what it's called, but I can't remember. It's been a lot of years. So you tin knockers, you'll know. HVAC guys. Yep, there we go. Now we're going to put all this stuff together using Teks screws. If this was a dryer, you normally wouldn't want to use like a Teks screw. You wouldn't want to use something that perforated inside that tube because you wouldn't want lint and stuff getting trapped to it. But there is going to be no particles that are going in this. The only thing that's going in that tube is going to be like vapors and fumes. So Teks screws will be just fine. Actually, I'm sitting here fiddling around on this little bench when I got a nice big bench here. Let's use this one. There. We'll try to make up everything right here down on the ground. It'll be a lot easier. So now we're just going to put on our 90. And not that it matters, but I tried to put that seam up so you really don't see it. Like I said, it probably doesn't matter, but just me. Yeah, now we'll put a few screws in it. There. So that's where our flexible piping will come off, and then we can hold that in front of our work where our fumes are, or we can slip it over the exhaust, the motorcycle to the exhaust or whatever. Our fan now is going to go on the other side. You guys that are regular viewers of this channel, you'll know that I try to do my best to not breathe in fumes and breathe in welding fumes, because that's super hazardous for you. I wasn't always that way, but I think as you get older, you start thinking about that stuff. It kind of matters. When you're younger, you don't, at least I didn't anyways, I didn't think about that stuff. Rarely, if ever, did I wear a mask. So you can see this is just pretty straightforward. It's just an inline fan, depending on which way it's going. I'm not sure. It's either, you know, we'll have to start it up and find out, but we want it going that way. Oh, there we go. Well, airflow right there. That's all we needed right there. I want this so that the cord probably comes out the top. I think that would look the cleanest. Mm-hmm. There. That's about it right there. Now we just got to hang it and put on our flexible duct. We'll put our flexible duct on last. Now you could wrap this all the way around and come back and make a little ear. We don't have enough to do that, so I'm gonna have to figure out what I have, and then I'm just gonna make little L brackets, and that's gonna have to suffice. Sometimes it's all about making do with what you got, you know? All right, so I want four hangers on it. So it'll be one here, and then one at the other end. And we've got just about 13 inches of material, so we'll do about 3¼ inches per tab. Now all I'm going to do is just take a pair of pliers and grab one of these and just put an ear on it. Just grab it. So I'm going to put the nose of the pliers right between these two holes and just fold it over. You can even do it on like a hard surface. Just like that. Make yourself a 90 degree bracket, and then this right here will go up into the ceiling overhead, and then we'll get one right into the side of the metal. So. Like I say, guys, sometimes it's just all about improvising, you know what I mean? Making the best you can out of the things that you got at hand. So what I'll do is I'll hold this up to the ceiling and make a little mark right where the joist is, so we know we need to put a hanger right there. Now I'm just going to measure over, and we need another hanger right at 64½ inches away. So now we'll make another mark at 64½ inches. So now that we have our marks on this pipe, now we can just simulate it being up on the ceiling and get our brackets on it. And I'm just going to put one screw in it now. For now, we could always put another one in it right there to help holding it right after we get it in. Alright, it's time to put this in. Let's lower down the table so we can get some room here. I'm telling you what, guys, this table right here, I absolutely love it. I mean, I never imagined I would get as much use out of this thing as I do. You know, the bike's off and on this thing all the time, and, you know, lawnmowers, snowblowers, just servicing all this stuff. And then, plus it's gone wheels, so it could roll out of the way if you needed it to. It's a little heavy, but I don't ever need it to. But, yeah, it just works really, really slick. If you guys are considering a workbench, and you guys do more than just weld and stuff like that, and you work on other stuff, this is really great because it saves your back. You know what I mean? I'm getting a little bit older, and it's harder getting stuff up and off the floor onto a full height workbench, and this goes up to a full height, like a full height workbench. So yeah, pretty slick. Off camera, I made a couple little marks on the ceiling so that it's straight within the room. I didn't want it crooked, that looked silly, that bothered me. Put it on our mark, put a screw in it. Hold it on our mark. Down here, sometimes it's hard to film upwards. There. Now I'll do is I'll just go through and put a second screw in. Might as well. I mean, won't hurt anything. Probably don't need it, but why not, right? So now we'll open up our duct. We need a little bit on the far side, on the fan side, then the rest of it is going to go on the 90 degree side. So the fan side is right near a window, so we're just going to exhaust it right in front of the window. And it comes with clamps, which is nice. So on the other side of this banner, I have a fan. So what we need to do is I need to get this piece of duct to right here, to just this other side of the banner, because I have a puller fan that pulls air out of the room and it vents it out a window out this side. So all I need is just a short piece of ductwork right here, like 2 feet long. A piece of ductwork, that flexible duct that's 2 feet long, and we'll be in business. I'm gonna kind of stretch this out to get 2 feet out of it. 2 feet right there. I may need to get more of this stuff. Well, it's going more, I guess. Ah! Yeah, that's what I was afraid of. This stuff's not cheap either. All right, guys, so if you're doing this, don't force it. Clamp over it. There. I like it. Alright, now we'll put the down tube on. Oh yeah. Put a clamp on it. Clamp it. So I had this stuff, funny story, this stuff is made for sealing up ductwork, but you see how it's all shiny? I had an old beater truck that wasn't much to look at, but the bumper was all rotted out, so I put a few layers of this over the bumper to make it look a little bit better, so that's why I have this. Not because I'm doing ductwork on a regular basis, but just cosmetic reasons, but we're going to use it for our ductwork today. Let's see. Go around it a little bit and just cut it with a pair of sharp scissors. This stuff is almost like an adhesive aluminum foil. It's, you can listen to it, it's like metal. And it's super sticky and it tears easy. But that'll give us a nice, you know, that'll make the connection as tight as possible so we don't have a whole lot of air leaks, you know. Cut the pieces that we're going to need for the other side, but I want to show you a little trick that I do, not with just this, but with any type of tape. If you take the end of it, and one thing that you can do with, say, like Scotch tape, okay, is if you take the Scotch tape and fold a little bit of it back onto itself, you'll end up with a little tag like that that has no stickiness on it. So that way, the next time you go to grab the tape, you're not sitting there digging, because I've got big hands and I keep my nails usually trimmed pretty short, so I have a hard time like trying to get tape or Scotch tape. I mean, Scotch tape's the worst to get off if you've like stuck it down to itself, but put a little tag back onto itself, and there you go. You'll always be able to grab it. So, little quick tip, no charge for that. See that, guys? That seals that up real nice. Makes it nice, airtight. Covers the screws. Plus, it just gives it a nice finished look. But you wanna, you know, you don't want any air escaping out of this. Just so it's pulling the best it can pull out of this exhaust tube. Guys, check out this, how slick this is. So I just wheeled the bike up, obviously. And then you just crank this wheel here. that out. It's being held up on its own right there. But for safety reasons, I throw some straps on it just to be sure. It's all fun and games till you drop it off the lift. Wow, just cleared my windshield. And that back tire right there, that's what you call a Maypop. May pop now, it may pop later. But we got a new one that we're going to put on at some point. But yeah, that's what that is. But look at that. Just cleared the windshield. So let's see how this thing works. Yeah, I think I might need longer hose. Because I wouldn't always want to have it up on the lift to run it. And I could probably always get like some real soft, flexible stuff. Hopefully it's not overly loud. Oh, that's not loud at all. Oh yeah, it's got some pretty good air volume coming out of it too. So that's the only drawback that I see, is that that's kind of like floppy there. So probably what I would do is get a larger outlet, so go from like 4 to 6. That way you could like put it over the exhaust further, so you don't have to worry about it blowing off. But yeah, there's no fumes, and I like that it's kind of like rigid, because once I pulled it away, then it wasn't hitting on the bike again. So yeah, pretty slick. And this will work good too for just helping pull out welding fumes and stuff like that, you know. So yeah, not too shabby. And that's all there is to it, guys. I hope you found this video useful, and maybe you guys can use this to help ventilate your workshop. So new videos every Friday. Until then, I'll see you guys next week. If you're wondering about any of the tools that you see me using, I'll have a link down in the description. You guys can check that out. There's also a link to all kinds of other welding and fabrication videos down in the description as well. Until next week, guys, I'll see you then. Take care, stay safe. If this is something that you like, maybe consider subscribing, leaving a comment, or a like. Take care, guys. See ya. Come, come.